and welcome to the 64 Doors. Today we're going to open door 25. This is the archetype of love, and it has a pure, sweet innocence to it. This archetype sometimes feels confused when it's met by unloving acts in the world, because it doesn't know how to live without acceptance, love, and respect. This archetype is going to attract a lot of tests on its life path. It's going to have to feel the core wound. And by accepting this wound, this pain into its heart, the heart is going to be flooded open and the quality of universal love is going to flow through. Through a repetition of tests and shocks in the life path, this archetype is going to be initiated and it's going to embody the truth that love is bigger than anything else. And this archetype is often going to take on the role of a healer, a shaman, or a priestess. So let us look at how the 25 looks in human design and the gene keys and how we can understand it in our lives, especially if we have it in our chart. Right now we have the sun in both Pisces and Aries in gate 25. We have the earth in both Libra and Virgo in gate 46. And the sign part of the cross is 10 and 15. And that's also in two different signs. And all these gates are going to come out from the G center. The center has to do with love, direction, and identity. It's the cross of the vessel of love. And in human design, we explain it as at the very center of your energies is love. You have the love of the body, the love of humanity, the love of behavior, and universal love. You're here to be universally loving all things. You may be met with shock at some point in your life, and your challenge is to overcome it. And this is what we said before about the shock and how that actually deepens the trust and the innocence of the 25, and how it really has the faith that love can help us overcome anything. When we look at the circuitry, we see that the 25 meets the 51 and they are connecting the G center with the ego center. It's the channel of initiation and needing to be first. So it's the 25 that's attracting the shock, the ego, the will, you could say, in the 51. And that's how it becomes the sign of needing to be first. In itself, the 25 does. Internal motivators, the spirit of the soul, innocence, unconditional love, transforming pain into love, and healing wounds. This 25th archetype, it's also the third of the seven sacred seals, and it's healing the core wound of shame. The Achilles heel is melancholy about being insignificant, confusion when faced by unloving acts, and it's challenged by life over and over again. The positive attributes, sweetness, acceptance, optimism, faith, and purity. Then if we go into some of the patterns, so it's the victim of constricted breathing. In the gene keys, it goes from constriction to acceptance to universal love. That's the frequency band. So here we have the repressive nature, the ignorant. And it's actually not even wanting to look at your own pain and to repress it and to refuse it. And actually that just leads to your aura, you know, being full of that constriction. And then the reactive nature is cold. So you are unwilling to own that wound and you're often actually expressing it outwards through projection. And somehow your heart is closed off, so you can't feel it. You're just projecting it. Those are the negative patterns in the gene keys of this 25th. Here we see the frequency band again, and the 25 is the universal love and the 46 is the love of the body, and you can't have one without having the other. The shadow frequency is constriction and seriousness. Acceptance and the light go hand in hand, and ecstasy and universal love go hand in hand, and it has to do with a sacred wound. I feel like what's interesting as well is that this third seal and 25th archetype is it's starting this ring of humanity. So we went from the ring of humanity that had a lot of the keys that were after, gates were after each other, and now we're coming into a new ring where we also have those transits that we're going to go through in the next couple of weeks. And if we read about it, it's very much, you know, humanity's journey. So let's see if I can find it here. Coda ring. So it says, wounded from the outset, 25, you must do battle with your shadows, 38. Overcome the limitations of your mind, 17. Surrender your need to control life, 21. And find your true self before you can awaken. So that's really the journey. And we are going to go in this, in the same direction as they were told here. So it's going to be really weeks where we can come kind of far in our evolution, and every year we do it, right? We can go deeper in the new things that happen. I was speaking with Ashley that it could be so interesting to write something every transit and then do the same thing. Both look at what we wrote when we were in the programming partner, like you were seeing that we had the 26 and the 40, the 25 and the 46 are on opposite side of the wheel. So it can be interesting to note something down here, and then you see the programming partner if when you're half year later, when you are in the 46, and you compare these, because they have to do with each other a lot. So if there are themes that are maybe unlocked here that started here, and interesting for each pair of programming partners to do that. And also from one year to another, I can really remember last year for me in the 25, because I had a rib that was completely pulled out of place. And this year the pain came back in the 25. It was never really healed, but it really came back much more. So there is something with the transit. So year to year, it's just interesting to start tracking. We can also look at the I Ching. So we have the elements of thunder and heaven, and these are powerful. So it's kind of interesting that it says innocence, but it's also the same thing with love, right? It's the strongest thing that exists at the same time. And if we look at the dream arc, we can see that the stone is, or the crystal is diamond, which is also the most precious one. So you can see this is like a theme. And it's also special in terms of the astrology, because it's the combination, like we were saying, of Pisces and Aries. So it has the healer, the mystic, the poet, the mutable waters. And at the same time, it's going into that fire, to the initiation, to the new astrological year in Aries, the pioneer, the warrior, the adventurer. And it has that in it. We can also look at integral human design. We're going to see also the connection with the will center again. So we have that ego competition that comes in together with the 25, uniqueness and initiation. And what more? Programming partner, I think we looked at most of it. I hope that this will be a week of love and acceptance for you. It can also be a week when this transit activates old constriction and tension, and where you feel serious or cold, or this third seal of shame is coming up. And if you have these things activating, the most important thing is breath, because breath is taking us back to the body. It's opening up that constriction. It is allowing more space. And when we do that, we can be ourselves more. We can trust life more. And there are some also contemplations that you can do this week. For example, do you have anything that happened in the past that you haven't been able to accept or forgive? Do you know that there is a wound that you're not wanting to feel, where you're pushing down? Maybe this is a good transit for you to look at that and see if you're ready to let it go. You can also, when you are in challenging situations, ask yourself, what would love do? And maybe that can give you guidance. So it's a week that can be both beautiful and challenging. Often I feel like the 25 is easier than the 36 and the 22 that we were in, that were more messy and more the kind of like human suffering. Here we have a bit of a cleaner energy, but like I said, it can also bring up things that are difficult. So a week with a lot of possibilities and a lot of love, hopefully. Bye.